Hey, you guys. So I wanted to make a video because I have been changing up a little bit how I have been following people on Instagram. Now I'm filming this video as of March 2020. So of course things are going to change, but what's working for me now is something I really wanted to share because I was mass following. You know, I was following 300 plus accounts and it just wasn't sustainable for me. So instead of just mass following, I have gone to following 20 a day, which is something from a top coach who had recommended that was her number. And I thought instead of just mass following, I would rather be able to dig into these accounts and give them a little something while I follow them so that maybe they will follow me back. And I found that it's really working well for me. So what I do, whether you're brand new to coaching or you're just starting to navigate Instagram, is I go to my Explore tab to start out. And then I'm going to go to things that I'm interested in. Like for example, I love Rae Dunn. She is the designer, like home goods and stuff. I love her. So I click on Rae Dunn because I love that account. And there's a little little arrow right here. I don't think you can see it. But if you press it, it's going to come up accounts like this. Because the reason for that is if you're thinking of a really big name account, you're looking for like-minded people, right? Well, Rae Dunn has 320,000. That's a pretty big account. I would like a little bit of a smaller account to just have a smaller pool of people to search through. You know, it's not as overwhelming. So maybe if you go to somewhere close in your local, in your town or whatever, it might be a small account. It might be 10,000 or less. That's a great size account to really find and connect with people. So regardless, I'm going to go to a smaller Rae Dunn account, which is Rae Dunn New Releases, and that has 35,000. So it's still big, but it's not overwhelming. And I'm going to click on one of her top posts. And then it was a return policy update. So I'm going to click on who liked that post. Okay. Because if someone is liking a post, they are probably pretty active on Instagram. Now I'm going to go a step further. I'm going to look, scroll these people who have liked the post, and I'm going to look at someone who has a story. So that circle around their profile picture, because if they have a story, they are active on social media. And that is what I want. That's the kind of person I want. I don't want to follow random accounts who haven't posted for 6 months and wonder why they don't follow me back. So what I do is, this is what I've been doing lately. I click on a girl who has a story. And if they are huge accounts, I don't typically follow them. That's not my market. I'm looking for people that are moms and obviously have a smaller account. I'm not looking for people that are already involved in other companies or with network marketing and other companies, anything like that. So this girl doesn't seem to be selling anything. I like her page. So what I'm going to do is go to her story, see if there's something I can react with very naturally on her story. I'm also going to go to her most recent picture. Okay. So I'm going to click like on that. And I'm going to give her a comment if it feels genuine to me. If I don't feel like I should comment on anything, I don't. But if this is a picture of her son, I'm going to talk about something referencing her. I'm going to leave her a comment, and I'm going to click the follow button. Okay. So all that should take probably a minute to find someone and give them a little interaction on their story. If something naturally comes to you, and like and comment on their most recent photo, and then click the follow button. I do that for 20 accounts a day. It takes about 20 minutes, right? When I'm done, that's my growing my network on Instagram for the day. Because what I've found is with the commenting, more people are following me back than if I would just mass follow, because that looks a little spammy. It's also a lot easier for me to manage. So I have the app called Follower Reports. I paid $5 for it. I highly recommend it. Again, this is March 2020. This could change. But the next day, before I go to follow someone else, I unfollow anyone who didn't follow me back from yesterday. And the reason is, if they're active on stories, if they're posting, they're going to see that I followed them. And if they don't follow me back in the first 24 hours, they're not going to follow me back, most likely. And that's okay. So I don't want to be following a ton of people who don't return the follow. So I simply unfollow using follower reports, and I start my 20 over again. Now I always make sure I'm caught up with my invites, with my follow-ups, my unread messages before I grow my network, because that is still a vital, but it's something that I want to do after I'm finished with everything. Okay. So I hope that was helpful. I also wanted to share a little bit about how I track follow-ups. I don't really track a ton of follow-ups. I put someone in my digital tracker if we are actively having a conversation. So I follow up with every initial invite with a follow-up 2 days later. I don't track that. I'm only tracking someone who we've been talking, they're asking questions, and I want to make sure I don't forget to follow up with them. Obviously, once they become a customer or a coach, they become in my digital tracker as well, because I want to make sure that I'm constantly in contact with them. I'll probably make another video to explain that deeper. So today, I really just wanted to focus on how I find new followers on Instagram. I hope this was helpful.